Hello, I'm JDL. I'm from Amsterdam, the Netherlands. I'm 24 years old and I've been a professional street artist slash muralist for 3 years. I started doing graffiti as a little kid. I became a little bit of a rebel kid. So I decided to buy some spray paint and go on the streets and write graffiti everywhere, and then one thing led to another and I got into art education and I found out about street art, about making portraits with spray paint, and I practiced and practiced and practiced and I found a way to make art with the same medium as I used. I just hope the same as many, many years ago. I hope to grow and to become bigger, 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 and better, and better, and better, and better. And I'm dreaming towards the next level that's always 10 steps higher than I can imagine. And I really hope to find a bigger piece of the conceptual art that I want to put in my work. So I'm working towards that point now. Well, I think everybody just has one piece of music that fits them. And I see art as music, and a big piece of why I love art so much is expressionism as well. And if you use realism and humans and something recognizable as emotion, you get way more freedom to recognize something in a picture than if you use an image like a square for me, or abstract. It fits better with what I want to express. I think it's different in every time and place how people react or how it gets to the people, but of course it will always get to the people because it's in public space. So you will always influence the people. But to me, art, once again, is like music. For me, it's about finding something inside of me that drives me and something that I have been experiencing. And when I translate that to art, I notice that people can relate and people can feel what I feel, see what I see. And that's a way for me to talk to people without words. Differences. In some countries there's more freedom. In Amsterdam, for instance, it's way more easy to paint a girl with short pants than in Asia. In Asia they will not really like you when you paint a white girl. In Amsterdam, yeah, for sure. But it's the same, it's not only in art, it's everywhere. It's just culture, it's place, it's a huge difference. And it really, if you leave the same picture in several countries, there's always another picture. But that's what makes it interesting as well. The pressure, that's for me the biggest challenge, and also the doubt on yourself every time. Because every time that I start a wall, I start thinking like, oh, I'm not sure if I can do this, can I do this? And I start to hesitate, together with the pressure and the stress and working hours of 14 hours per day, and then no sleep and not enough food, no time to eat sometimes even. Every artwork that I make is like a frame of my life, but also probably of other people's lives, because every life has something similar. And this one is a frame about relationships, but not specifically a positive one. It's about needing each other rather than wanting each other. It's a visual based on that concept. That's why the girl has her hand on the boy's face, pushing him away with his face turning on the other side, and the boy does the same, and at the same time they're pulling on each other's t-shirt. A sneaky detail is that the pocket of the guy is inside out, so it's empty, and when you have nothing you need somebody even more. Life, really, it can be anything, but I always go to museums a lot, and I look at other artists and history. I even researched technology a lot to get inspired, but also movies, psychology, other people's stories, countries, culture, really anything. Music as well. For me, when I started already, I've painted with color a lot. But I just kept feeling so uncomfortable because I did not reach the picture that I want. It felt really plastic, it felt fake, it felt forced, and it didn't feel natural to me. Black and white pictures, to me, they were much more expressive, and the same in photography. If I look at a black and white picture, to me it's stronger than a color picture. So that's how black and white came in, and I never even lost it. And I still like it way better than color. Then the blue came in a later stadium. It was a big trip. We solved a lot of problems and we had a lot of obstacles, but in the end, I keep joking in my country when I leave for a festival, I say that I'm going in the army and I kiss them goodbye and I will never come back alive and blah blah blah, because there's so many obstacles and it feels like war sometimes, you know? And you have to fight together to fight all of the obstacles to make sure you paint the wall, you finish the wall, and you have your final product. And that's what we did, and we did it well. And I'm happy.